p.m. Eastern here on CRN Digital Talk. We talk about things in the sports world nobody else does. So listen in to me and Mike at 4 p.m. Pacific, 7 p.m. Eastern, right here on CRN Digital Talk. And go to crntalk.com for more information on other showtimes. And don't forget to take us with you by downloading the CRN app on the App Store.
Live across America, the PM Show with Mike Horn on CRN Digital Talk Radio.
Hey, welcome to the big weekend edition. It is the PM Show. Yes, I am Michael Horn. Paul Stern has joined us. Hello, Paul.
Hey, glad to be with you, Mike. What an exciting edition ahead today of the PM Show.
A lot of news in the week. Sad, exciting, and everything else in between. Settle back. So Muhammad Ali laid to rest this weekend, a memorial service and all this kind of stuff. This is, they say there will not be another boxer the likes of this guy. Lennox Lewis apparently talked to Muhammad Ali and tried to follow his sort of lifestyle in the ring. And so he's one of the pallbearers at the Muhammad Ali funeral. Were you a big boxing fan? Did you follow boxing during those days?
I am a boxing fan, so to say. I've watched it kind of growing up. I've seen it on TV, and on occasion I'll even catch myself getting almost captivated watching the bout on ESPN. It doesn't necessarily even have to be a title fight or anybody in particular. Just the sportsmanship of it all is something that is certainly unparalleled when it comes to, you can't find it in any other sport.
It used to mean more, though, when we were younger, didn't it? I mean, it used to, like, you'd want to know what Rocky Marciano was doing and, Leon Spinks going up against Muhammad Ali and all this kind of, Ken Norton and all this kind of stuff that was going on. It seemed like it was more of a sport then than it is now. It doesn't have the same luster. They used to have Friday night fights. They'd have them on, our parents listened to them on radio. That was a big deal to have a boxing match on radio. He's down, he's up, and they'd be doing this. Then when we were kids, they had them on TV and then on pay-per-view in the theaters. It was a bigger deal, I think, before than it is now.
Well, no offense to the late champion, but I think a lot of people have kind of taken a turn against boxing.
Yeah. I think, a lot of people think it's too violent, but there was always this idea, I heard a story that Muhammad Ali's father tried to talk him out, or somebody in his family tried to talk him out of it, and so he went to talk to his father, and they asked the father to try to talk him out of it, and then the father was instead showing him a left hook or a right jab or something, showing him to get into it. It was more of a big deal back then, and it was... there was more, I don't know, it just seemed like it had more stature than it does now. And I think there were some injuries. I think you guys were looking in the studio at some of these boxing matches where a guy was killed or something in the ring. And I think that kind of took the luster off when Muhammad Ali was there, and doing his rope-a-dopes and all that kind of stuff over there and hanging out with the broadcasters. And every broadcaster's got a story to talk about him. Howard Cosell was synonymous with Muhammad Ali. It was a deal. And then I think Howard Cosell pulled out of boxing. I think at one point he got out. Was it after the Lee Doc Toe incident? What happened? He decided he wasn't going to call boxing matches anymore.
I think it was the final two Ali fights that really kind of put the
why?
Cap. Ali took a lot of punishment.
And they said that he might have had this early on stage disease that he had, Parkinson's disease at that time. And Muhammad Ali said that he always felt that the Parkinson's was hereditary and didn't come from the boxing. But he did take a lot of beatings at those last fights.
Yeah, it was the Larry Holmes and the Trevor Burbick fight that really kind of, unfortunately, kind of cast a little bit of a shadow on the storied career of Muhammad Ali. He just didn't have it in him to be able to put up the
fight. To put him down.
He
did the rope-a-dope. He would sit there with his hands up there and take the hits and stuff. And at the time when he was doing some fighting and was an objector to the draft, and he was his status was taken away in the ring, for gosh sakes, when he did that. But he felt so strongly about not going to the Vietnam War that he just said he wasn't going to go. And instead of like Elvis, who went, there was a whole big backlash in this country. Some people hated Muhammad Ali for a while because he wouldn't go and fight for his country. But he felt strongly about it. And now, if we look back at him now, and there's a lot of great things said about him. And he was the greatest in the ring. And he believed in what his ideals were. So you got to give him some kudos for that, I'll tell you.
Love. Life can be unpredictable. That's why you should take control of your family's future now with an estate plan bundle from LegalZoom. Not sure whether you need a last will or a living trust? LegalZoom's network of independent attorneys in 48 states can help you decide which one's right for you without billing by the hour, since LegalZoom isn't a law firm. Plus, updating your estate plan as your family and assets grow couldn't be easier. Enjoy your life. Use LegalZoom for the legal stuff. LegalZoom. Legal help is here.
Welcome to Staples.
Hi, Staples guy. We're moving offices and it's a giant pain in the...
Bubble roll?
What?
Well, Staples has bubble roll, packing tape, all kinds of boxes, everything you need to move and all at low prices.
Great. That's a giant load off my...
Packing peanuts?
No.
Shrink wrap?
No, but now moving will be a walk in the...
Packing tape?
Sure.
Get low prices on everything you need to move at Staples. And right now, a six-pack of Scotch Move and Store Tape is $19. Staples. Make more happen. Offer ends 6/25/16.
Welcome back here to the PM Show. I'm Michael Horn along with Paul Stern. We're talking about boxing here with Muhammad Ali. And so let's talk about this a little bit here now. So Muhammad Ali, you said these last two fights, Paul Stern,
the last two
pretty
fights
bloody
were,
there.
They were the Holmes fight, right? They were the worst. There was the Holmes fight. I think that was in 1980, and then Trevor Burbick a year later in 81.
And Cosell was out. He wasn't calling those fights.
I think he called one or two of them. Cosell might have been on hand for the Holmes fight. I don't think he was there for Burbick. But
who was the guy that punched Lee Docto and killed him with a? Was it Jerry Quarry or somebody? I forget who it was. Some guy came into the ring and just happened to hit the guy with a punch, and wham, the guy went down and he was dead.
Jerry Quarry, another known case of just a boxer that just took too many hits to the head. This guy.
It wasn't Quarry, it was somebody else. I forget who. Tomas will look it up.
Jerry Quarry was a great champion,
yeah,
though.
He was.
In his own
well, they
right.
all were good champs, but I mean, there is the, boxing got to be that brutal sport. Like, why are we still doing this? And yet, when it was really a sport and you boxed. You know, they did. Then they were calling fights early, and it sort of lost the luster a little bit. And then Tyson came on the scene.
Oh, yeah, Mike Tyson came on the scene, and anybody who thought they were anybody, by the time they came up against Tyson, they weren't anybody.
But boxing to me, and there's some great, you go back many years with Jack Dempsey and Sugar Ray Leonard and all these guys, and Sugar Ray Robinson way before that.
Oh, who was the guy at the turn of the century? Was it Jack Armstrong? Was there a guy named Jack?
It was the Jack Dempsey that was always
great. I know Jack Dempsey. This was a big guy at the turn of the century, though.
Yeah.
Unbelievable fight.
And there was Floyd Patterson. And so you knew all these names, and people looked at it and they enjoyed boxing, and it just got to be very very well promoted and very well done when Muhammad Ali was there in these great boxing matches. So he will be missed. And I saw something with his daughter saying that she doesn't care about the boxing. She just misses her dad and wishes her dad was still around, and your heart goes out to the family. He's gone way too young. It's a sad thing.
Of course, he did a lot of stuff after boxing, which I think actually probably gave him a greater reputation than his boxing career, to be perfectly honest.
The work that he did to advance help
towards those that have Parkinson's, the notoriety and all that good stuff.
Remember, he carried the torch in the Olympics?
The Olympic torch. He lit the torch.
Yeah. So it's amazing stuff.
Yeah, it's amazing stuff. And again, he's a legendary figure. I don't think that there will ever be another one like him.
Since we're talking sports, Gordie Howe, the legend from hockey, passed away also, and he was full of life. We did some interviews with him. He came on our show.
That's kind of a bad deal.
I didn't know he was in poor health or anything, and it's like,
he could go forever.
Hockey fans look up to him. Hockey players, Wayne Gretzky always talks about Gordie Howe, the great Gordie Howe. There's a legend in hockey, and he was playing hockey, once again when that sport was at its luster going in there. Now it's hockey has expanded over the years. Instead of like boxing going backwards, it's gotten bigger and better than ever before. But it was the guys like Gordie Howe that really brought it in when you had a couple of like a baseball team with a couple of great franchise players. He will be missed. I miss Gordie Howe already. Nice guy, good family man, and what can you tell? Also in the news, Maria Sharapova, she's been banned for tennis now for 2 years. She is the former number one tennis player in the world. She got a 2-year suspension from the International Tennis Federation after testing positive for banned drugs. Melatonin, is that what she was taking, I guess? And if the ban is upheld, it may end the career of her and the fame that she's had in the past decade. She sent out a statement to her fans saying she would be appealing the decision, adding, quoting now, "While the tribunal concluded correctly that I did not intentionally violate the anti-doping rules, I cannot accept an unfairly harsh 2-year suspension." Sometimes these people take something, they don't know what's in it, and they get tested and they get stuff shows up in their blood.
That's kind of a charitable way of looking at
it. Well, here's the thing. I've got that Czech cultural background, and we love good poppy seed. And if I ate poppy seed and you tasted it, you would show like you got opium in your system. It would come out with that test. You have to be careful if you eat poppy seed. It can show up in your blood test. Tomas, you're a big poppy seed guy. Maybe it's opium. I can't remember which. No, that's what I'm saying. You know what I'm talking about. Kids, you got to be careful on this stuff. We'll let Tomas jump in here as he's line producing the show here for us today.
Definitely. You got to watch everything that you eat nowadays.
I had a lot of onions.
Watch those. I could tell, by the way, when you came in here.
For the broadcast.
I found this great, they say it's probiotic, and I love sauerkraut, and I like it warm, but my uncle said, I don't like sauerkraut warm, I'll eat it cold. And I found some at this supermarket, and it says probiotic, and it's a dill garlic sauerkraut. Ooh, awesome. And it is quite tasty. You take a little bit of that with your meal, and I'm telling you, there's no gas there. Just, you belch that right out. It is really good, I'm telling you. I can eat some right now on the show. Could you send somebody out for some sauerkraut?
For some reason,
The dill garlic one is good. People stay away from me.
I have just a gut feel that Maria Sharapova's problems have nothing to do with any kind of garlic or sauerkraut or poppy seeds, to be perfectly honest. But again, I could be wrong.
We'll find out.
I could be wrong.
I had lunch with the great Eldersky, Larry Elder, today, and I must mention that he was recently on the Stuart Varney show. And you know, when they go on the show, when you're a contributor to these shows, and Larry's on Hannity, he's on all these shows, and he's on Stuart Varney's show, and Stuart, they say, well, what are you going to want you to talk about Donald Trump talking about the judge and all this stuff? He says, yeah, but I want to talk a little something about this. And they, well, what is it? And the producer talks about that apparently some years back, and this is from Larry Elder, and he's researched this. Hillary Clinton, when she was running for senator, Bill was running for something, she got very ticked off at somebody in their campaign staff who was Jewish. And she used some words, the B word, and that she called them a Jew, and she said this stuff, and then denied everything. And Bill Clinton said, well, she might have called them the B word, but she was just upset. But about 3 witnesses heard it. There was a story written up in the BBC about it. So what's worse? Calling this guy a Jew bee, or is telling somebody that they're Mexican and that they're not going to be taken care of it? I mean, it seems like Hillary did something worse than Donald Trump. And I'm not condoning Donald Trump. I'm just saying the media is very one-sided here. You want to pick apart? Let's be right across the schedule there and see what's going on. So I'm going to research that story. But here's the kicker of me telling you this. So Larry gets on the show, and Stuart Varney comes on and says, you know, Hillary Clinton said blah, blah, blah. And so it's like Stuart Varney came up with this story and then wanted Larry to comment on it when Larry did all the research. So Larry was great. He said, I've been talking about this on my show for a few months now, and Stuart, you and I seem like the only ones talking about it. But I would not think Stuart Varney would do anything like that, would he? I mean, come on.
I need to talk to Larry.
You? Why?
I've got to ask him how his windows are.
His windows?
I've been hearing a lot of commercials for Larry talking about his windows on his home and his good friend Aaron.
Oh, he's doing some window commercials.
Yeah, and then Larry goes, Aaron, tell him. And then Aaron goes, I don't know what dialect it is, but he goes, your house could be made out of potato chips. And That's the guy. That's the guy.
He won't destroy your house. Your house could be made out of potato chips, and he won't damage it.
And he won't crack one.
Really?
Yeah, and apparently he's done some work on Larry's house. Or as Larry says, a friend of mine's.
Oh, okay, so maybe it's not Larry's place.
He does like a commercial with Hugh Hewitt. It's the most interesting, Hugh Hewitt, who did the debates on CNN.
Oh, yeah.
The one that Donald Trump had some...
By the way, Hugh said something that was in the news yesterday about he didn't like Donald Trump, and he was going to... These guys are going to destroy themselves if they go against Trump. What they don't get is the country is fed up with politics as usual, and they want something new. And so these guys, I don't know. Some of these guys are walking on a thin edge there. This is what the election is going to be. It's Trump against Hillary, so get used to it.
Both you, and Larry Elder are on the Salem Radio Network.
Yeah, we carry it all on CRN3. You can tune it in right here at our CRN Digital Talk radio platform. In fact, we shouldn't be talking about Larry because he's on opposite us, and I don't want anybody to tune away. Stay with us. We'll be back with more great stuff, including secrets about Kiefer Sutherland. Don't miss out on this.
You didn't have to say that, though.
I just did. I'm sorry.
Let me take just a moment or two, if I may, and talk about a great place to eat. That's right. For you folks anywhere in the eastern San Fernando Valley, drop into Bob's Big Boys. That's right. In Sun Valley at 8274 Sunland Boulevard. Now, everybody remembers the name Bob's. They're getting bigger and bigger every day. And little old Bob carrying the hamburger in his checkered overalls is the same Bob that you remember from back through the years. And, of course, if you want to go in for a great lunch, remember their classic burger, the original double-deck hamburger combination. Delicious 100% pure ground beef in two patties with American cheese, lettuce, and our famous Big Boy special sauce. The name is Bob, and I think when you go in, you'll say, by golly, I'm sure glad that I found this restaurant because it's good for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. They've got all kinds of things, and all you have to do is remember. Bob's Big Boy in Sun Valley at 8274 Sunland Boulevard. It's a great place to eat.
Trying to sell your old car? Instead, donate your vehicle to Heritage for the Blind. Pickup is free, and your donation is tax deductible. Just call 1-800-785-9618. Heritage for the Blind accepts cars, vans, trucks, and boats, whether they run or not. Call right now and receive a free 3-day vacation voucher to over 50 locations. Call 1-800-785-9618. Donate your car today. That's 1-800-785-9618.
The smartest way for you to get the lowest prices on your plane tickets, domestic or international, is to call SmartFares, first or last. But you've got to call us before you book your plane tickets. Fly anywhere in the world, fly anywhere in the U.S., and Smart Fares can save you up to 75% on your plane tickets. We have the lowest airline ticket prices on over 500 airlines. And you've got a great 12-hour free cancellation window. Plus, with our live agent help, you can always get fast help and fast answers. So on your next trip, maybe today, maybe tomorrow, how about right now? Pick up your phone and call SmartFares. Plus, save up to 75% on your plane reservation. So call right now. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644.
Attention CRN listeners in Arizona. Now all of your mortgage needs can be handled by Advance Capital Mortgage. Looking for a reverse mortgage, refinance, new purchase, or just to streamline your FHA and HARP? Our rates are great with dozens of lending solutions. Call Advance Capital Mortgage, 855-437-8421. That's 855-437-8421. 855-437-8421. MBO 91903, MLS 716936.
Welcome back to the PM Show Weekend Edition on CRN Digital Talk Radio. I'm Michael Horn with Paul Stern. Got the news of the day. Tomas pressing the buttons. Courtney Kader, our executive producer. That Finding Dory, it's a Disney movie. It's that's been a cash cow for fish stories, but it's been deadly for the fish. There's a rift now in the exotic fish community. They believe the movie, Finding Dory, could bring a financial boom, but also a massacre to the fish population. Now, it's a movie, for gosh sakes. A bunch of fish dealers say they've stocked up on blue tangs, dory species, expecting a rush once the movie premieres. The same spike happened when they did to clownfish after they did Finding Nemo. And apparently these tangs, the tang fish, they're not cheap. One goes for like $40 to $60. There's big money to be made. Many experts say that they've worried that tons of blue tangs will die when the parents flock to buy this fish for their kids because they require a specific exotic tank setup. One enthusiast put it, fish novices will kill these creatures. Well, if you're spending $40 to $60, I think you better get the proper stuff. Well, yeah, did you ever raise fish? Did you ever have an aquarium?
No, I did not. No, I can't say that I did.
We've taken great care of those sharks. I think they're still in that tank out there in our auto office over there. Who's in charge of cleaning that, by the way? Have we assigned that to anyone?
Okay, Oscar.
No, he passed away.
Oh, no, you're kidding me.
Yeah, Oscar passed away. Oscar the fish guy. So, Tomas, do you sometimes scrub that down in there, anything?
Every once in a while.
Yeah. Those sharks in there, like, they're pretty happy no matter what. I wouldn't put my hand in there, that's for sure.
I liked Oscar. He was a nice guy.
He was a great guy. It's been gone for a while.
Nobody told me.
Yeah, well, then now you know. Sorry to break the news to you right in the national radio show. Oscar was our fish guy for many years. HBO's John Oliver has paid $15 million of medical debt belonging to 9,000 Americans and forgives it all in this big, he says, the biggest TV giveaway of all time. John Oliver made the giveaway on the Sunday episode of Last Week Tonight. He bought the bad debt for under $60,000 and could have chased the debtors, but instead he decided to outdo Oprah's 2004 car giveaway by forgiving the debt. And the event came at the climax of a piece about debt buyers. They buy bad debt, they pay the debtors, and even if they don't, they legally can, and in many states requires no paperwork to buy or collect the debt. So this is what he did. He bought it and gave it away. That's pretty good. Nashville, listen to this. This is a good story. This TV show Nashville, have you watched that, Tomas, at all?
I have.
Yeah. What's the other show you like? You like the other one, the R&B show there, right? What is it?
Empire.
You've been watching that?
Bet I got a whole bunch of them on my TV.
Yeah, what's
TV
the deal? This year, Empire was really big last year. It's not that big this year, is it?
It's still pretty big.
Well, anyway, Nashville is going to be joining the club of TV shows that come back after cancellation. And so CMT and Hulu have joined forces to bring Nashville back from cancellation. And everybody's going to be excited about that. So we'll see if that punk kid that's got her contract going does something else.
Well, it makes a lot of sense for CMT to have Nashville versus regular
network. You watch that show, Raina James has a lot of problems. He's got kids, you know, he's got two kids from different fathers, and the eldest one wanted to be with her dad. The dad finally comes back and marries into the family, and then she gets all bent out of shape and then goes out with some floozy and signs one of the worst record deals of all time. She comes back at the end of the show, and the guys are falling off roofs to try and save drugged out country singers. It's kind of fun. I like the show Nashville. Kiefer Sutherland is in the news. This is another great story. Two great stories here on today's show. Nashville coming back to CMD, and our buddy Kiefer Sutherland, who was on this show talking about his music. What are you filling out over there? Are you applying for another job while you're doing the show here, Paul Stern? You're busily just working some kind of a... It looks like you're applying for another job. Are you quitting or something?
No, I got the people over at Orel's Auction coming by the house, and I got to fill out some paperwork for them to pick up some... some furniture.
Well, can't you do it other than when you're on the air here talking to the millions of people that are tuned into us here? You're filling out, it looks like paperwork over there. Do you need me to do a job reference?
No, it's Orel's Auction.
I don't think so. Sounds like you might be doing something.
No, it's Orel's Auction.
Blatantly applies for jobs while they're working at their one job. They're filling out a job form.
They used to be our neighbors here at the CRN Digital Talk.
Everybody's cleared out where we are here. What's happening? Is there some kind of a change
Orel's
coming?
Tomas, come on. Look at this. Orel's Auction.
I don't know. You can hold it up to the camera, but I don't think anybody believes you're listening. It certainly looks like some kind of a job application to me.
Anything.
When are you going to go to work for Orel's Auctions? Are you going to be an auctioneer?
That was not the plan. The plan was for them to pick up a couch or two. That's all. Just want them to pick up a couch.
I was at the airport.
You don't
recently.
Want to buy a couch, do you?
I thought I saw a guy who looked a lot like you at the airport the other night, but it couldn't have been you.
Could I sell you a couch? I got a fine Arizona leather couch.
Anything we can use in office here at the office? You know, to go ahead and sit down and relax and have
for the right price.
Maybe we could undercut Orel's Auctions. All right, well, you go ahead and fill that out. You got a few minutes here in the break, but then come back refreshed and get ready to go on the show. My gosh. Guy's filling out a job request form right here while we're doing the broadcast.
You experiencing pain? Back pain, shoulder, elbow, or hand pain? Pain from a sports injury? If so, schedule a visit with Dr. Michael Sheps, the leading expert in laser therapy for pain management. Call 310-873-4422 or go to drsheps.com. Experience Epic T, the breakthrough laser therapy system that Dr. Sheps developed to make you pain-free in less time. Laser therapy is a non-invasive, safe, and effective in-office procedure that penetrates deep into your skin without damaging the tissue. It perfectly targets areas of pain to promote fast, natural healing. Relax your muscles, ease muscle spasms, joint stiffness, and arthritis pain while increasing blood circulation. For over 25 years, Dr. Sheps has helped Olympic athletes and sports enthusiasts alike get back in the game. Schedule your visit with Dr. Sheps at his Brentwood office in California. Call 310-873-4422 or visit drsheps.com. That's drsheps.com, 310-873-4422.
Any Napa guy knows, and science proves, the best minivan is the one you've already got. Part kid transporter, part drywall mover. Who cares if the faux wood grain is a little faded? That was a platinum package option in 1987. With over 400,000 parts and a little Napa know-how, you can keep anything on the road. Because it's not old, it's vintage. That's Napa know-how.
CRN listeners, when you come to Southern California, stop by a great restaurant, the Dresden Restaurant at 1760 North Vermont Avenue in Hollywood. Enjoy great entertainment, like the music of the legendary Marty and Elaine at the world-famous Dresden Restaurant. The Dresden was a location for the making of the movie Swingers. Now you can swing with stars Marty and Elaine. Plus, enjoy great food, too, like French onion soup, artichoke hearts, and many other great appetizers. Seafood? There's salmon, shrimp scampi, New Zealand orange roughy, halibut, Lake Superior whitefish, and specialties like veal marsala, piccata, and parmigiana. Plus, we've got a great roast rack of lamb, chicken piccata, and cordon bleu, and pasta dishes, too. Steaks? Filet, New York, Chateaubriand for two. Much more, too, including pork chops, prime rib of beef, and an incredibly extra large cut of prime rib. It's the Dresden Restaurant, open for lunch Monday through Saturday and dinner Monday through Sunday. Check us out at 1760 North Vermont Avenue or call 323-665-4294.
Hi, I'm Joan London, and if you're worried about your parent or a loved one living alone like I was, and you want reliable senior care information, then call A Place for Mom, the nation's largest senior living referral service. With one phone call, you'll get free information on assisted living, Alzheimer's care, nursing homes, even important financial information. It's a free service, so call now.
Call now, 800-704-6182, 800-704-6182.
The smartest way for you to get the lowest prices on your plane tickets, domestic or international, is to call SmartFares, first or last, but you've got to call us before you book your plane tickets. Fly anywhere in the world, fly anywhere in the U.S., and SmartFares can save you up to 75% on your plane tickets. We have the lowest airline ticket prices on over 500 airlines, and you've got a great 12-hour free cancellation window. Plus, with our live agent help, you can always get fast help and fast answers. So on your next trip, maybe today, maybe tomorrow, how about right now? Pick up your phone and call SmartFares. Plus, save up to 75% on your plane reservation. So call right now. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644.
I thought I heard Kiefer Sutherland come into the discotheque. I think I was mistaken.
Holster your weapon!
Is that you, Kiefer?
Holster your weapon!
Apparently there's something. Everybody please get on the floor and get funky! Let's do the holster your weapon dance. You take it, Kiefer! Let's holster
your weapon!
Thank you! I am the Funkmeister. Playing the funky sound. PM Show. Michael Horn, Paul Stern, and Kiefer Sutherland.
Holster your weapon!
Tomas is here as well. I think he just... Tomas, get your security crew over there and see if you can calm down Kiefer Sutherland. He's a very excitable guy today.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling you right now. Anyway, Kiefer Sutherland has not ruled out bringing Jack Bauer back for the new series 24 Legacy. This is important. If they want this show to succeed, Kiefer Sutherland must be in the show. No doubt about this. Kiefer's a producer on the show, along with executive producer Howard Gordon. Kiefer's an executive producer. And apparently, Howard Gordon said at the ATX Festival in Austin, Texas, and according to Deadline, that the character, quoting now, he said, the character feels alive, end of quote. But they're unsure if a reappearance would happen in a future movie or a new series. See, they always say that and then they back off. Just bring it back like they're doing Nashville. Bring Bauer back. Jack Bauer back to 24 Legacy, that's what I think. And the writers would first have to cross the hurdle of springing Bauer from the clink, because the last time we saw him at the last episodes of the last season, a couple of years back, he was flown to a Russian prison for crimes at the end of 24 Live Another Day. So he's in Moscow right now. That can't be fun. That can't be fun being in the clink. Moscow probably is bad enough being boring, but let alone being in the clink. With Colonel Klink, for those of you old-time TV land people, would be tough. And that's where Jack Bauer is supposed to be, in jail. Anyway, the possibility of Jack Bauer, the character's return, is surprising, since some viewers perceived Kiefer Sutherland's new ABC drama Designated Survivor as Jack Bauer as the President of the United States, because that's this new show that's coming up. Called Designated Survivor starts this fall, in which Jack Bauer is locked in a room, and then the president or somebody gets killed, and he's got to take over the whole country. The Designated Survivor is more of a political drama. It won't see Kiefer Sutherland is not going to say lines like,
"Holster your weapon."
Thank you, Kiefer. Right on cue. He's not going to say lines like that. He's not going to probably even have a gun anyway. The audience is just knows and loves Kiefer as Jack Bauer. So a return to Jack Bauer would be a nice change of pace from the version of Kiefer we're going to start getting to see in the fall. Remember when he was also doing that? They had that kid that was had problems and was. Remember that show? What was that thing called again? This show, Tomas?
I can't remember the title. I'll look it up.
I think that kid is on Gotham now. I think that's the same kid. Who was Bruce Wayne as a kid. That's what I think. Double check and see if I'm right about this, but I know my kids. But anyway, Kiefer's going to start, it's going to be crazy in the fall. He's got this Designated Survivor. He's also doing a tour and playing music. It also remains unknown if ABC plans on running the series for a full 22-season run or just a short-order 13-episode season. And if it's just 13, Kiefer wouldn't have much time to appear on the new 24. I mean, if it's 22, he wouldn't have much time on 24. But if it's the latter, he could have just enough time for him to get it in and make it happen. So this could be time for Jack to rest easy and save the day on 24. And then you'd need to get to Chloe back as well, too. David Letterman, Tom Brokaw sat down with David Letterman for a long, wide-ranging interview that's set to air this Sunday night on Dateline NBC. Boy, they actually did shave his beard. Have you seen Letterman? He looks like a goof with a big old beard on it. I saw a picture of him walking around the sand.
Like Randy Quaid.
Yes.
He looks like Randy Quaid.
Yes, that's exactly right.
And not like Randy Quaid from like 20 years ago, like Randy Quaid like today, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, anyway... Yeah. David Letterman was on The Late Show, and he goes all in on his replacement, the late night biz in general, and he even talks about Donald Trump. The late night shows are terrible. I will not even watch one of them. They're just terrible.
What did he say about Donald Trump?
I don't know. He
can only imagine.
Letterman hosted Late Night and then The Late Show for CBS for decades. He retired last year, and he spoke candidly about Stephen Colbert, who has thus far really struggled to get even a couple of people to tune into the show. This poor Colbert, he's like, I saw him do an interview with Bill O'Reilly, which was okay. That was the one show I thought maybe I should lay off of this guy. Because usually when I see him, it's like, does he know anybody's watching him? And then probably nobody is. I don't know.
I caught Piers Morgan coming to the defense of Donald Trump.
You did?
Yeah. It kind of makes me wonder
Piers was on, he's one of those guys who was on Celebrity Apprentice, so he knows Donald Trump more than we do.
That's right.
For Piers to say that, that's a big deal, because I would think Piers would trash him if he could. He's a critic.
I don't know what they got on in its playtime slot on CNN anymore, but kind of couldn't be any worse.
Yeah, who took over for Piers Morgan?
I have no idea.
Yeah, I don't know.
Are they doing some kind of made special, like a CNN special?
Yeah.
Made for TV special?
Yeah, Touch. That was the series that that Kiefer Sutherland was on this thing, and it was the first season aired on Thursday nights, and then the 13 episodes awarded for the first season, and then they had two episodes season finale going on there. That was good. The kid, he was able to kind of see things that people couldn't see. Jake was this kid, and moved from job to job, and he was a special needs kid. He was autistic, but he would learn things, and things would come to Jake in a certain way. So interesting stuff. We'll tell you more about that later. Anyway, so Letterman's going to be talking about Stephen Colbert, who has been struggling to get ratings. Letterman also told Tom Brokaw, I can't believe they've rolled out Tom Brokaw for another interview show. This is great. And Letterman told Brokaw his thoughts on Colbert and some interesting tidbits about women in late night. He says, I don't miss it. It's interesting. I thought for sure I would miss it. And then the first day of Stephen's show, when he went on the air and the energy left me, and I felt like, that's not my problem anymore. I've kind of felt that way ever since. So that's why he's got the beard and everything. He's looking at other aspects of his life, and he's focusing on that. And the guy's got a lot of money, so he should just rest and relax. So he says, I don't know why they didn't give my show to a woman. That would have been fine, I would have been happy for their success, and they're doing things I couldn't do. That would be great. So, I don't know, but they have some women at late night, don't they? Kelsey, whatever her name is.
That isn't on the air, is it still?
I don't know. She was doing that.
Chelsea Handler.
Lately, or Handler or something, yeah.
I haven't heard of that show since we used to have Pam McNeely here with us on the show.
Yeah, I say bring back Johnny Carson. I miss Jay Leno. I thought he was just perfect.
He did this lift thing at the Magic Castle in Hollywood.
He did? Oh, tell us about that when we come back.
For life's aches and pains, choose Blue Emu Continuous Pain Relief Spray. It works fast, and it's easy to use. Designed to work odor-free in all those remote areas. It works here. It's odor-free here. It works here. Blue Emu Continuous Pain Relief Spray. Fast-acting, easy-to-use, odor-free pain relief for all those remote areas. Available at Walmart, Walgreens, CVS, and other fine retailers.
QL1, this is Control. Does Rocket Mortgage require me to fill out a bunch of paperwork?
That's negative, Control. Rocket Mortgage by Quicken Loans is the first on-demand mortgage machine that quickly and seamlessly imports your financial data. You can go through the entire mortgage process on your own and completely online.
Copy that, QL1, but if I wanted to speak to someone, do you think they're out there?
They're out there, all right. I've made contact before. In fact, according to J.D. Power, they've provided award-winning client service for 6 years in a row.
Roger that, QL1. It's nice to know they're out there, wherever they are.
Detroit Control. They're in Detroit. Over.
3, 2, 1.
Rocket Mortgage at QuickenLoans.com. Push button. Get mortgage.
Rocket.
Visit for cost information and conditions. Equal housing lender. Licensed in all 50 states. NMLS ConsumerAccess.org number 3030.
Welcome to Staples.
Staples guy, you know what business people hate?
Stale coffee?
Ink.
Right.
We have to have it, and it's so darn expensive.
Well, Staples just cut ink and toner prices.
Really?
Add in our 110% price match guarantee, and our prices are unbeatable.
Great. Know what else every business owner hates?
What?
Paper cuts.
So true.
For unbeatable prices on ink and toner, Staples. Make more happen.
Staples will match price plus refund 10% of the difference at checkout for items from retailers operating online and retail stores. Limited time. See store or staples.com for details.
Holster your weapon!
Welcome back. PM Show Weekend Edition. I'm Michael Horn. That's Paul Stern. And over there is Kiefer Sutherland as Jack Bauer. Thank you, Kiefer. I love the guy. So that series Touch that Kiefer had on Fox, it's a the kid's role was David Mazouz, M-A-Z-O-U-Z. And that is the guy that's in Gotham. He plays Bruce Wayne, for gosh sakes.
Yep.
What a talented actor this kid is. And he's gotten rid of his autism, which is amazing to me. I don't see a trace of it in the character of Bruce Wayne, do you?
No, I don't.
But he definitely had it when he was playing the role of Jake in Touch, But the kid is a miraculous recovery. It's good for him. Speaking of, I'm just kidding. I know he was an actor. All right, so here we go. Some people are going to write letters if I don't explain it. Follow along. Now you're reading the newspaper. You're looking at the want ads for some more things to apply for. What is your problem today?
I was just checking.
You're just reading the newspaper. You're filling out forms.
No, it's what's trending.
Get Mr. Stern a sandwich so you can sit here and eat during the show?
I was checking out things that are trending this weekend.
What is wrong with you?
Good stuff happening.
What's trending? Some of your show prep. I love it when you do it right here on the air. And don't give me the ads for the Trader Joe's like you normally do on some of the shows that they got apples for sale.
No, there's a lot of things happening within the, like, there's a musical stuff happening around town. I just wanted to just check it out, things see what's happening.
Anyway, speaking of Kiefer Sutherland, as we were, he is, his music is doing well. He made his debut on the Grand Ole Opry. Did you hear about this? Now, he's won an Emmy, a Golden Globe, a SAG Award. He's earned, people love this guy. He's been a team roper on the rodeo circuit, and now he's gotten Thursday night. Tuesday night he was on the Grand Ole Opry stage, and when it came time to make his debut as a performer on the Opry, Kiefer wanted to deliver traditional country music. He says they were the oldest school country songs that we have. And he played a song called Shirley Jean and Not Enough Whiskey, which both appear on his new album. And he concluded his set with a cover of Merle Haggard's The Bottle Let Me Down. I got to hear Kiefer doing that.
Yeah, I give Kiefer a lot of credit because I guess a few years back, he let the talented duo of Marty and Elaine record their album at his studio.
There you go. They were in the movie Swingers.
That's right. They conduct shop over at that Dresden restaurant there in Hollywood, for those of you coming into Hollywood.
I want to go there and do some drinking one night. Maybe I can call myself a cab or a Uber or something and get over there and enjoy myself. It might be good.
You should do that. Maybe you might get a ride, and again, maybe not.
I could see. Now, ABBA is in the news. I like the group ABBA also. And you know when they had that the new ABBA and the old ABBA, according to Comandante Ronaldo Beaton, when they made the movie, he was just... it's just ABBA, but he thought there was a new one and an old ABBA. There isn't. It's just, you know, the wives left, and then these guys were just, Benny and these guys were just producing things. Anyway. It's been 30 years since ABBA performed together. 30 years!
It's been a long time.
Count it! And they had big, huge concerts all over the place. Anyway, they joined forces on Sunday, and they celebrated the date that Bjorn and Benny first met 50 years ago. These are the geniuses behind it. Bjorn is 71, and Benny is 61. And weren't they married to those women, too?
I don't know that.
I don't know if they were.
I don't know that.
Anyway, they marked five decades of friendship, and they threw a party in downtown Stockholm. And the remaining members of the group, Ani and Agathina, I think, they were also at the bash. Ani Frid is 70, and Agathina is 66. And the two women dedicated a performance of their 1980 song, Me and I, to the men, who then decided to join them on stage and perform with them. I think they should go back on stage on circuit tour. Come on.
During their day, they were a couple of the most beautiful women I think you could ever find at the industry.
Probably looking pretty good, 66 and 70. Come on. It marked the first time that they had all performed together since 1986. The band broke up in 1982. Do we have pictures we can hold up of them? I'm sure they still are looking pretty good.
I think one of them looks like Betty White.
Go back to filling out your forms.
I couldn't help it. That was a joke.
You just went for a cheap joke when these people performed and sang their heart outs on stage. You get up there when you're 66 or 70. Just get up anywhere. Try and walk up the steps. Talk to Robert Conrad and I this way. It's tough for us to get up there. It's something else. The Grammy Award-winning artist Ed Sheeran's 2015 song Photograph was a top 10 hit in the United States, sold more than 3.5 million copies, but a pair of California songwriters have claimed a copyright lawsuit filed Wednesday, and it borrows heavily from the song, and they want at least $20 million in damages. And did you hear that Gawker is going bankrupt? Because here's the story I heard today. I heard that a few years back, Gawker outed some very rich business guy, billionaire, and said that he was gay. Oh. And since then, the guy has come out and said, I am gay. What's the big deal? And said that he's gay. But he just didn't like Gawker so much that he funded Hulk Hogan's lawsuit. And just this place is trashed and it's bankrupt.
Isn't that something?
Goodbye, Gawker. Some of these things I just don't like when they
I honestly don't think I don't think I've ever even looked at Gawker, to be perfectly honest.
Well, apparently you did. You've looked at Anna and Agathina and said they're still pretty good looking at 70 and 66.
No, I said back in the day.
I wonder if they wore
those
little mini skirts when they got up there.
I said back in the day they were pretty good looking. I said right now, I don't know.
How about Loretta Lynn? She can still bring it. She and her family are dealing, this is sad, with the sudden death of her grandson. And so she postponed two shows. This grandson passed away this week. This guy was 47 years of age. Jeffrey Allen Lynn lived and worked at Loretta's Ranch in Tennessee, and he's survived by his three children. The cause of death not announced. Sad news. Luke Bryan. Here's a guy. He announces a farm tour. He's supporting students with his farm tour, and he's been doing this since 2009. He's the CMA. I can't believe he's the Entertainer of the Year. Can't we bring out, like, Merle Haggard? He's dead, and I think he's a better CMA Entertainer of the Year. Sorry, Luke. That's the way I feel.
Hi, friends. This is Larry Minetti. Go to LarryMinetti.com to get my book, Aloha Magnum. You'll read all about the wonderful guest stars like Carol Burnett, Elvis Presley, Frank Sinatra, and many, many more. Also, there is an episode guide and my favorite recipes that I really cook at home. I will include a free signed photo with every book. Get Aloha Magnum at LarryMinetti.com. Order now. Aloha.
Come to Angelo's and Vinci's Ristorante in Fullerton, California for authentic family-style Italian dinners. Come to Angelo's and Vinci's and celebrate your party or event in one of our festive banquet rooms. Angelo's and Vinci's, Fullerton, California, 550 North Harbor Boulevard. Named the Orange County Hot List Top 5 Italian Restaurant for 7 years in a row. And a Top 10 Pizza Restaurant by Gale, featuring traditional and award-winning pizzas. Offering Sunday champagne brunch from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. just $16.95. Choose from over 20 items plus create your own personal omelet. Delicious lunches, including our express lunch buffet, $8.95 with over 15 items, and dinner 7 days a week. Getting married? Angelo's and Vinci's won this year's Wedding Wire Couples Choice Award. You can talk to our experienced staff of wedding coordinators. We treat you as guests at your own wedding reception. It's all at Angelo's and Vinci's Ristorante at 550 North Harbor Boulevard in Fullerton, California. Call 714-879-4022. 714-879-4022.
Hi, I'm Joan London, and if you're worried about your parent or a loved one living alone like I was, and you want reliable senior care information, then call A Place for Mom, the nation's largest senior living referral service. With one phone call, you'll get free information on assisted living, Alzheimer's care, nursing homes, even important financial information. It's a free service, so call now.
Call now, 800-704-6182, 800-704-6182.
The smartest way for you to get the lowest prices on your plane tickets, domestic or international, is to call SmartFares, first or last, but you've got to call us before you book your plane tickets. Fly anywhere in the world, fly anywhere in the U.S., and SmartFares can save you up to 75% on your plane tickets. We have the lowest airline ticket prices on over 500 airlines, and you've got a great 12-hour free cancellation window. Plus, with our live agent help, you can always get fast help and fast answers. So on your next trip, maybe today, maybe tomorrow, how about right now? Pick up your phone and call SmartFares. Plus, save up to 75% on your plane reservation. So call right now. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644.
This is Kiefer Sutherland from the Grand Ole Opry last Tuesday.
Each night I lay the borrow when it's over. Not feeling anything, don't close the tide.
I love this tune.
But tonight your memory found me much too sober. Couldn't drink enough to keep you off.
Let out Luke Bryan, the next country music entertainer of the year, Kiefer Sutherland.
Apparently the recording engineer took the night off.
I was going to say, I guess the studio quality has left the Grand Ole Opry from the old days.
Bootleg or something.
This is not an old AM radio. Anyway, Luke Bryan, I listen to Kiefer in the background talking about Luke. He's the reigning CMA, Country Music Association Entertainer of the Year, and he's announced dates for his 8th annual farm tour. It visits 8 states from October 5th through the 15th, and a portion of his ticket proceeds are going to the Luke Bryan Farm Tour Scholarship, which aids kids from a farming family with communities on the tour plays. Kiefer Sutherland singing for you here. This is a good one.
I didn't know that you could smuggle in a cassette and a quarter and into the Grand Ole Opry.
Tomas apparently got this bootleg recording. Pretty good. The Monkees, by the way, they've earned the highest charting album since 1960 on the Billboard 200 chart. The new album's called Good Times. Their first studio album since 1996. It's Big Finish. Let's finish it. Holster your weapon! You have Grand Ole Opry and Kiefer up there. Can we get him back on the show? Thank you very much. And Kiefer has that classic when he leaves the stage, he just shouts at everybody, holster your weapon. I love it. People dive under the chairs.
Wonder if he was selling CDs at the lobby after the show.
I hope they record a little better than that one. By the way, will we have that one available live on bootleg? I'm just kidding. I should have said CRN Worldwide Exclusive in there because I talked through it. That's good enough. Celine Dion has announced plans to launch an all-encompassing lifestyle brand. The new line is going to have home goods, activewear, beauty products, and more. I think she's going to do it with those ladies from ABBA. Should be kind of good. Let's see. Oh, here's the science behind. Why? Are you okay?
I don't know what that meant.
I don't know. You were just talking about them.
Celine Dion's a good-looking lady.
Yeah, so is the people at ABBA. Anyway, according to some new research, this is why mosquitoes favor certain people. The amount of CO2 that a person gives off determines how attracted they are to mosquitoes. So if you're farting at some barbecue,
you may be just some kind of a delicacy.
Let me tell you. Apparently, the female mosquitoes who carry diseases like the Zika virus have special receptors that let them sense CO2. I do. It's called a nose. Anyway, people who are hyperactive and have just finished working out, and people who are larger in both weight and height are all targets for mosquitoes because of their CO2 emissions. Excuse me. As for the blood type argument, mosquitoes definitely prefer type O blood over the other types. What type are you, Paul?
I don't know.
Mosquitoes also seem to prefer people who drink beer, while some lucky people are born with natural odors that repel them. That's our show. By the way, California has raised the tobacco age from 18 to 21. That's good news. And on Monday on the show, we'll talk about how Google can predict how successful an employee will be.
I wonder what kind of retailer was selling cigarettes to 18-year-olds.
Mr. Chang up at the... I think up at the 7-Eleven. I'm not quite sure. I think he was arrested. They took him out in cuffs last week. That's our show. If you missed anything, go to our website, crntalk.com/thepmshow. For our producer, Courtney Cadera, for Paul Stern, I'm Michael Horn, saying download our cell phone app, £2.50, say CRN Talk. Thanks to Tomas for finding some great music, too. Have a great weekend, everybody.
Holster your weapon!
Which was most appropriate because that was your theme.
Are you tired of hearing your favorite talk radio show sound like this? What if you could hear your favorite shows in crystal clear, high-definition digital sound? Well, with CRN Digital Talk Radio's 6 channels of high-definition radio, you can now hear all of your favorite hosts like you've never heard them before in CRN HD. The difference.